So hey, I got more bad news. The damage is a lot worse. Welcome back to another episode of We Rebuilds. So today we're gonna work some more on this 2018 Audi S5 Prestige. We're gonna give it a quick wash and start pulling off more components and get deeper into the damages and see how bad it is. If you like our videos, please consider subscribing, like, share, drop a comment down below, turn your post notifications on. Check out our Instagram because there's a lot of sneak peeks on Instagram. If you want to send a message, our email is down in the description below also. So, let's hop into it. We washed the car off a little bit, so today I'm just gonna start pulling off some of this stuff, get into the damages, see how bad it is, and then we'll go from there. So let's not waste no more time, let's go. We have our bags on our marker to mark everything where every screw comes from. And I'm gonna have a paint marker or something to mark all the little small damaged pieces. And we're just gonna dig into this today and see how bad is the damage. Get all these broken plastic pieces out of the way. I guess this is from the broken headlight. This whole headlight was damn crushed in the accident. All dented. Feels like aluminum though. Yeah, it is aluminum. Now I should be able to get to that screw back there once I pull off all of this. I mean, doesn't look good, guys.
It's a lot of damage on this engine. Right there. But let's keep going. Got this piece out. So now this piece is out. Put it over here in the pile. So what I'm gonna do later is just get a vacuum and vacuum out these two pieces, and hopefully nothing went inside of the turbo and damaged it. As you can see here, the oil filter housing, it's cracked, the whole thing all the way up. So we're gonna have to pull that out too. And all these pieces that like have plastic pieces melted inside, we're gonna get those out. So let's keep working.
Sensor right here.
This sensor is broken off into the engine block, but I mean, it has this piece where, you know, I could pull it out. It's more and more damage.
I guess this is the other piece that should go on top of right here. That's also go. And I guess those hoses that I just pulled out attaches to this piece right here.
So hey, I got more bad news. The damage is a lot worse. I don't know what I'm gonna do yet, but it's a lot more damage than I thought. But I'm going to show y'all all the damages and the more damages that I found apart from right here, which I took off most of this stuff already. So, let's go. I can't believe it. It's bad. But we probably just have to get a parts car or something and use the parts car to rebuild this one. But the damage is really bad. Well, let's go and show y'all what's happening. So as you can see right here, the engine mount is cracked on this side. Yeah, so the engine mount is cracked. It's not even cracked, it's broken completely off. Because see, you got some other pieces around here shaking. Let me see if I could take it out. I think I can get it out. Try to take this piece out. Yeah, but I'm gonna just leave this piece here for now. I can't really get it out. So I'm just gonna leave it right here for now. But yeah, that engine mount is broken. On this side, you can see this piece is broken. There's a hole in here. The intake manifold, it is broken on this side. And this one over here, it's cracked from when the frame pushed on it. Now we're about to go under the car. So now, if you look, you see it's the collision moved the transmission out of place, because the whole transmission pan is tore open. This piece is broken up top right here. And I want to say this looks like the transmission mount is cracked. And also this side of the transmission cover is tore open. So I'm hopefully it's just the cover is torn and not the transmission itself. But that's why in the back, the right side of the exhaust is pushing out more than the left side of the exhaust. But I'm gonna try to take this cover off and see if we could find anything else. As you can see, the plate is just cracked that holds the transmission. The transmission didn't get any hit at all. So, but the transmission pan, that's what took the impact. So, but apart from everything else does look good. So, I mean, that's a good sign so far.
And if you look up top right here, a lot of broken pieces and clips and wire harness. So we'll probably just have to get a new wire and harness too. But there's a lot of sensors and stuff that are broken. But that's pretty much it.
So that's gonna be a wrap for today's video on Wee Wee Bills. We got most of the, we have jumped into it. See how bad the damage is. So we're gonna need two engine mounts. The transmission mount is also broken. So, I mean, everything. So the whole engine has to come out, get the framework done. Once the framework is done, get inside cleaned up, put the new frame rails in, and then all it, after there is just putting the engine back. And we probably need to get a parts car, because once we have a parts car, then we could take some components off and get all these wiring harnesses, because I'm finding some used wiring harnesses for like $700. The airbag is like $650 for each airbag. That's the knee airbag and the steering wheel airbag. And don't forget about $550 for each current airbag. So there's still a lot of parts. I don't know why all these parts are so expensive, but nevertheless, we'll see how that works out with that parts car. But next episode, we're probably gonna pull it down some more
And once we pull down this car some more, we're going to take the engine and transmission out all at once. So I'm just trying to do some more research to find out if I need to drop the subframe in order to get this engine out, or if there's another way of going around it without dropping the subframe. But if not, I have to drop the subframe. I got some quick jacks that I could use to drop the sub, to lift the car up high enough so we could drop the subframe and take the engine and transmission out. But I know it's a lot of work. I have a lot of stuff to think about. Now, I it's kind of getting to that breaking point, but I'm not stopping just yet. That's why we stay positive throughout everything that we do, right? But I'm just waiting and thinking of my next move and see how I'm gonna do it. But keep watching our videos. Like, share, subscribe, turn your post notifications on. If you're a new viewer, please consider subscribing and post it and share it with all your friends so we could keep the YouTube algorithm going. Don't forget to hit that like button. Check out our Instagram, We Rebuild. The online school will be up soon. I'm trying to work that out little by little as I go along, and we're getting merch in. So we're trying to get some key rings in, some key rings that goes around your neck also, and some shirts. And now winter is coming in, so we'll probably have some jackets also. So that the online store will be coming out soon in order for y'all to buy and support the build, because as I said, Audi parts are expensive and I need help from you guys to make this happen. But until next time, stay positive, stay motivated.